Motorcycles, padlocks, typewriters, beer, just a few of the made-in-Milwaukee products that gained fame in the 20th century. There was also a machine built for speed, a rocket-powered vehicle that set a land speed record more than 50 years ago. In our Sunday morning spotlight, Michelle Fiore takes a trip down memory lane with some of the crew members who brought the legendary Blue Flame to life.
That's my first hot rod motor.
It was just a hell of an adventure. This is the X1, something you'll never forget. If I remember right, it was
Ken McCarthy's
problem.
Got at least 1,000 pictures to keep the memories close at hand.
My granddaughter put this whole thing together and displayed it at her school.
It's photos from the 3 years of building the rocket-powered car in Butler, and also from that exhilarating, record-breaking day, October 23rd, 1970, when the Blue Flame met up with the Bonneville Salt Flats in Utah at an average speed of 622.4 miles per hour for the measured mile.
The driver was calling the speeds out as we went down the track. 400, 450, 500, 550. 600, 650, he said, we did it.
So what was it about the Blue Flame that made it go so fast?
It was a small car. It was light. I think it was only, 3,600 pounds. And it had quite an acceleration. And the motor was only this big, not this big, huge jet, you know, that oversized. And it put together real well.
The quest to build the world's fastest car started in the late 1960s when McCarthy reconnected with friends he'd made growing up on Milwaukee's north side at 35th and Center.
So when I got out of service, I came back from Vietnam and I worked at a gas station for a little bit. And Pete called me and said, hey, you want to build the fastest car in the world? I said, yeah, right.
You know? Pete is Pete Farnsworth, who'd been tinkering with cars since he was 14.
For my 14th birthday, I bought a car, which was a wreck, that used to race at Soldiers Field. Three of us pushed the car into my dad's garage, and my dad lost the use of his garage for a long time.
In his early 20s, Farnsworth was into drag racing in Union Grove with some neighborhood kids as his crew.
My wife would go down to the local drugstore and buy a handful of different popsicles because we didn't allow any drinking in the garage.
An idea surfaced, and Farnsworth and a couple other guys formed Reaction Dynamics.
And I started on the design in 1963, and by 1965, I had found a propulsion system that was safe to use at a drag strip.
The Institute of Gas Technology and Illinois Institute of Technology got involved.
That was part of the lure for the gas industry, is that they were looking to promote liquefied natural gas at that time. And they were in the infancy of trying to figure out how to promote it. And they tied this rocket project and youth and the space, you know, going to the moon and all of that. They thought it was a great usage of their money. It was designed after aircraft construction. We wanted the driver toward the rear so he had a good idea visually of where he was going. He was going 600 miles an hour. Traffic, I mean, things go by in a hurry.
The surprise was the first time we ran it. This thing was so fast, it was unbelievable.
From start to finish, it wasn't easy. The build team found the design to be stable, but the motor didn't exactly perform the way they wanted it to.
And that was built by Galaxy Manufacturing in New York. In fact, that looks good right there, but the motor's blowing up. It just looks good that way. Maybe I shouldn't be telling you that, but so we sent it back to New York. Here, see, this is how it blew up. This is the motor. It just busted up like.
Setbacks even happened in the final days when they arrived at the Salt Flats with the Blue Flame on a trailer.
We were ready to go, 22nd of October, but the wind was too high. The 23rd, when we got there, was 25 degrees. And the peroxide motor like that liked to be warm. So we made a short pass from Wendover, Utah, towards Salt Lake City. And then we turned the car around at the other end. Now there was heat in the motor.
50 years later, the building where Reaction Dynamics crews built the Blue Flame is still here, and we got a look inside.
I-beam just was along here.
For McCarthy, memory lane's pretty special.
Partitions weren't there. None of this was here. Mm-hmm. This was all open.
He recalls the handful of guys who worked hard in this Butler garage with one goal.
A lot of nights spent here, a lot of days, a lot of nights. A lot of long days, a lot of long nights.
What's it like being back here for the first time in 50 years?
This is weird. We were just some guys that wanted to try something and somehow pulled it off. I'd have done this thing for nothing. That's how much I like tinkering with cars.
Today, the Blue Flame's on display at the Sinsheim Museum in Germany.
They have since moved it to the front entrance of the museum, so everybody coming in has to go by the Blue Flame. So we're happy with that. They're taking good care of it.